Suppose we were told a fleet of spaceships with highly intelligent aliens has been spotted, heading for Earth, and they will be here in a few years. Suppose we were told these aliens might solve climate change and cure cancer, but they might also enslave or even exterminate us. How would we react to such news? Well, 6 months ago, some of the world's leading AI experts warned us that an alien intelligence is indeed heading our way, only that this alien intelligence isn't coming from outer space. It is coming from our own laboratories. We must act now, or within a few years, we might lose control of our planet and our future to an alien intelligence.
Mark my words, AI is far more dangerous than nukes.
The good case is just so unbelievably good that you sound like a really crazy person to start talking about it. And the bad case, like, lights out for all of us.
Look at this timeline. It's a ticking time bomb. Each year shows us a different AI expert's estimate for when we'll develop a technology that will change everything. Artificial General Intelligence, or AGI, is an AI that is smarter than the average human. Elon Musk thinks AGI is coming by 2026, and Dario Amodè, the CEO of Anthropic, thinks AGI is 2 to 3 years away. Google DeepMind chief AGI scientist Shane Lay thinks we'll have AGI by 2028. Sam Altman and Jensen Huang estimate AGI by 2029.
Everyone has now gone from 30 to 50 years, which was the estimate a decade ago, to 5 to 20 years.
The consensus is moving towards AGI in the next 1 to 10 years. Just 4 years ago, expert forecasters and AI scientists predicted that AGI was 20 years away. Now, they think it's just 3 years away. You can see just how surprised people were by GPT-3 and GPT-4. 4 years ago, experts also predicted an AI achieving genius-level IQ on the Mensa test was 20 years away. 3 years ago, they thought it was 10 years away. 2 years ago, 6 years away. 1 year ago, 3 years away. Now, an AI has scored 98th percentile on a Mensa genius admission test. Yes, AIs are literally genius level now. So what's going on? Why have these timelines shrunk so dramatically? It started about 8 years ago, when AI started beating humans in specific tasks way faster than predicted. In 2016, experts predicted that AI wouldn't master the Japanese board game Go until 2028. But that same year, DeepMind's AlphaGo beat one of the best Go players in the world, Lee Sedol, a full 12 years ahead of schedule. Sedol retired in 2019, saying, "Even if I become the number one, there is an entity that cannot be defeated." But what about the more complex game StarCraft, which has far more variables? Experts predicted human-level performance by 2022. DeepMind's AlphaStar achieved Grandmaster status in 2019. If anything, this trend is speeding up. Experts predicted that AI could write a high school essay by 2026. GPT-3 did that in 2020, getting the equivalent to an American high schooler's C+ grade. In 2022, GPT-3.5 moved on to legal exams and scored 213 out of 400 on the bar exam, putting it in the bottom 10% of human test takers. And just months later, GPT-4 scored 298, putting it in the top 10%.
90% passing the bar is better than the human rate.
The same technology experts thought would struggle with writing high school essays is now beating most American law graduates. So why are we smashing through past predictions? Well, that's where things get worrying.
It scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows. And the rate of improvement is exponential.
The last big breakthrough in AI capabilities was when transformer technology was introduced in 2017, which let AI models process all parts of the input data simultaneously rather than sequentially. This is what made ChatGPT possible. Since then, AI progress has been exponential, as researchers figured out that the more resources they committed to AI, the more compute and letting AI models read and analyze more and more of the internet, the better their models got at virtually all tasks.
It's reading more of the internet, and it's just throwing more computers at the stuff that it's read on the internet. Yeah. And out pops out, suddenly it knows how to explain jokes. You're like, wait, where did that come from?
Yeah. Or now it knows how to play chess.
For now, more money and resources directly translates to more intelligent AIs. To date, Microsoft has invested $10 billion into OpenAI. And the CEO of Microsoft AI, Mustafa Suleiman, predicts humanity will be training AI models that are 1,000 times larger in the next 3 years. So it looks like this huge investment in Transformer-era AI has put us on a fast AI timeline. But AI capabilities will increase even faster if this massive investment gives us AGIs that are capable of recursive self-improvement. Imagine thousands of highly skilled AI scientists working on the next versions of themselves. At first, the improvements might be measured in weeks or months, but once they produce new AI models with superhuman intelligence with the same goal of improving AI capabilities, we'll get the same advancements in a single evening as we got in the past few years of humans working on the problem. Current AI models already write code, and AI improving through self-learning has happened before. AlphaGo Zero beat the world's best Go player, Lee Sedol, without using any data from human matches. It trained by just playing against itself, running tests over millions of simulated games, until after 48 hours, it played better than any human on Earth. AI is now designing the more powerful chips it runs on, creating a recursive loop that is leading to exponential acceleration. The CEO of NVIDIA says we're obviously less than 5 years away from AGI because current AI is already helping to create the chips its future iterations will run on.
In fact, none of our chips are possible today without AI. Literally, the H100s we're shipping today was designed with the assistance of a whole lot of AIs.
Sam Altman is so convinced by the current rate of progress that he's looking beyond AGI at ASI, an artificial superintelligence.
Now, I no longer think of like AGI as quite the endpoint. That would take us to like 2030, 2031.
That will be a system that can eclipse all humans combined at all cognitive tasks, just like Stockfish destroys us at chess. So why aren't more people talking about this? This comes down to human psychology. It's hard for humans, even experts, to build an intuition for exponential growth. Take the rate of human economic growth and innovation, for example. The world in 2024, with smartphones, nuclear power, and space travel, would make zero sense to someone from 1750. It would blow their mind because so much has changed in those last 250 years. But a person from 1500 would be a lot less surprised if they were transported forward in time to 1750. People were still riding horses, fighting with swords, and sailing in boats. The reason for that difference is because the rate of growth isn't linear. It compounds over time. Inventions like the microscope or computers make it easier for new inventions to happen at an even faster rate. So it's not simply that we're making strides, it's that each stride is longer than the last. Understanding this compounding effect is crucial for grasping how human progress has accelerated over time. But despite us living through and benefiting from exponential economic growth, humans, even experts, intuitively expect the speed of growth in the next 30 years to look a lot like the last 30 years and project a steady linear progression into the future. We draw a straight line upwards from the past, assuming that we've already reached top speed and are going to carry on cruising without realizing that exponential growth actually looks like infinitely increasing acceleration. In exponential growth happens fast. Let's say you have a piece of algae in a pool that doubles in size daily. If it takes 30 days to fully cover the pool, on what day will the pool be covered? Not day 15, day 29. One day before you have a pool full of algae, it's only half full. Right now, all indications are that for future AI progress, we're at day 29, at the knee of this graph, just before things get real crazy, real fast. The unintuitive nature of exponential growth is why AI timelines have been consistently underestimated, even by some experts who think we're on an exponential curve. Because it just feels wrong to say that the same advancements that used to take decades will soon take place in a few months, then every week, then every day. So we're probably making two mistakes about AI. Not only are we underestimating just how soon AGI will arrive, we're also underestimating, or just being unable to imagine, what exponential growth in the intelligence of another species looks and feels like. We can't intuitively grasp just how much more intelligent and advanced AI will be than us once that exponential growth takes us beyond human-level AGI soon after 2030. I'd love to describe in more depth what super-intelligent AI will be like when it passes human levels of intelligence. But that's kind of the point. That would be like asking prehistoric humans to predict modern-day space travel. They're just not gonna know. The closest we can get is looking at the most advanced chess AI model and then imagining that it just doesn't beat us at chess, but at everything. And that it's interested in playing and winning games that we don't even know exist. Okay, so should we be worried? Heads of frontier AI labs think AIs may become 1,000 times more powerful than they are now in 3 to 7 years. How do you control an entity that's smarter than you? There are no historic examples of a species being controlled by a less intelligent life form. We don't even know how to control current primitive AIs. Sure, we can control what they say, but like any dictator will tell you, controlling what someone says is very different to controlling what they feel, think, and plan in secret. Even AI researchers don't really know how their own invention operates. It's a black box that they give inputs to and tweak to get the right outputs without really knowing what it is they're tweaking. It's better to think of AI as a fundamentally alien intelligence. AI safety experts have warned us for years about the danger of developing technology we don't understand.
50% of AI researchers believe there's a 10% or greater chance that humans go extinct from our inability to control AI. And we already said you would not get on that plane if that was the chance that the engineers who built the plane told you was gonna happen.
Now, like I said, I don't know what it would be like to interact with a superhuman AGI or what that AGI would want to do to you, but if you want my best guess, watch this video next.